you can see that it was about published. You should go look at some of it.
I did email you. I saw it. That's why.
No, I did not. I haven't even looked at email in weeks. I don't look at email. Have you looked at it?
What email?
The one you say he said. Thank you. She's been with other personal matters today, and so neither one of us have looked at it.
No. What is it? What was the email?
I never said that. I said personal matters. I didn't say it was a doctor. I said personal matters.
What was the email? What did I miss?
I don't know. He said he sent an email. Oh, act like a bear.
Oh, the one you're sending right now that you haven't sent yet?
He said he already sent it to us last night. Why did you send it? Neither one of us read it.
Well, it might have been just in your head just because I...
What did you send it, though? I've never seen it.
Wow.
And I can't look at it.
It looks good in print, though.
You came to me in the shower. All my best ideas.
You came in the shower?
No, that idea came in. All my... You know, it probably next to God and God.
I get my little mountain about like this.
What it says is, act like a paramour. Paramour Action Workshop and Drama Factory, John Blythe, Paramour Director. A comprehensive workshop featuring multiple camera video, providing immediate, objective feedback. Nice. The same practical techniques used by generations of paramour, Drews, Lanes, and Costello for over 200 years.
Wow.
Today is 8 o'clock p.m. If you're not having fun,
that's nice. That's tight. It's clean. Can we announce that we're going to do the show or not?
It's up to your buddy. If he wants to do it, I'm in.
Oh, who's my buddy?
With the guy with the videos. The high acting thing.
Oh, well, he'll say yes to whatever I bring him. So if that's the only one I hold up, the answer is yes. We have a green light.
Well, we had a chance to talk that day.
We have a green light. He'll do it. He'll do it just because I asked him. He does it. You know how much he's charging me for using his stage? You know how much he's charging me to use that stage?
It doesn't really matter when they're holding it, when the tech guys are holding you up.
Okay, but you're not answering my question.
No, I have no idea how much.
He's charged me nothing ever.
Well, that's a nice deal.
I get to use electricity, phones, coffee, whatever I want. He charges me nothing ever.
Yeah.
He's my friend.
That's because I'm doing a webcast for him at his place.
Well, I like it because it's close to my house. I like the people.
Getting things better.
Cool, what is his name?
I can only listen 1% at a time, and now I missed what you both said. Sorry.
Okay, I'll be quiet now.
No, I want to hear what you both said, but I just missed it.
Well, we'll start with Joe.
What did you say, John?
I do a webcast on most Tuesday nights.
No, I didn't. How come I haven't been a guest?
You want to come down?
I'd love to.
Oh, you'd be a great guest.
I even think that'd be phenomenal, but what show, when, where, how? Let's go. Let's go do a show.
It's
Tuesday night. That's tomorrow night. Do you have a guest tomorrow night?
I'm sending Mark a text right now and see if he doesn't have a guest.
Yeah, I'll be your guest. Or if you have a guest, we'll come in and upstairs.
If you have a guest, we'll do it next
week. No, if he has a guest, we'll come in and surprise everybody. We'll just watch your show. Maybe we'll videotape it.
We're going in half an hour late because we've only had another
guest. Oh, shit, I can go an hour and just get started. Where do you want to start?
Where do we got to be? At what time?
It's 6th and Alameda.
Can we also interview Raven, or do you not want to be there?
Oh, yes, I'd love to.
There you go. Would you like
awesome.
To be here?
Yeah.
Is this radio or television?
Webcam. Live.
Do you use video or no video?
Video.
Good, yeah. Can I also bring in my own cameras and capture my own feed?
He'll provide the feed to you.
But I want to copy my feed that I own the rights to.
I understand.
But if he'll give us rights, that's fine. But I do want footage I walk out with. I don't shoot anything. I don't walk out with footage I own.
I'm sure he'll give rights to other raw footage except for Mark for I say the art system.
Whatever.
Because, you know,
I own everything that I'm on as part of my IP. That's the way I only do a show.
I act like I own.
I don't act. I do. Except with Lorne Michaels. He's the only fucker
I find these pictures of myself on Getty Images.
It's at Art Share.
I'm sorry, LA Art Street, but he shoots the video at Art Share a lot. He's the guy behind the camera at Art Share.
So where are we shooting?
He's on the board of Art Share.
Because I used to take a writing course there.
From Carmen Vega?
No, from Paula Gillen.
Where is it?
It's at
the Arts
in Alameda.
Oh, yeah, we can be there in 15 minutes from now. It's 20 times.
They demo the bridge.
Oh, no, I know back doors. I'm a back door man.
So is that where it is, though?
Yes, it's right at 6th and Alameda, right near the corner. There's a machine shop downstairs. He rents out, like, skulls and artists and welding. And upstairs, there's a video studio.
Okay. Can you give me the exact name of the place with the exact address?
Yes, I will. Okay. Let me text him.
Well, can we come in and at least watch the show? Oh, even if we're not a guest, can we come and watch the show?
Yes, absolutely.
Right. So, we still need the address.
Okay.
I'm just going to drop in a grab mail. Oh, shit. The house keys in here, the big chain of keys. If not, they're in the center thing, I hope, because I didn't bring them with me or so, and I'm wasting time stopping
there. Yeah, there we are.
Good. Thank you. I just got to drop in and grab some mail real quick. This is where I've been getting mail for 30 years. I think if they're going to blow me up, they can take the FBI with them. Because the FBI is here. And live
the FBI
view.
Is everywhere.
Live view, no, but they're here.
The FBI took over the post office.
And they took over everything. Right here. Yeah.
They took over the post office?
Yeah, come, you gotta see it. It's not there anymore. It's in a whole new location. It's all changed, John.
The post office
is all FBI. Well, be careful what you're talking about. We're monitoring.
Mike? Yeah. What's the name of that theater?
All right, two cops here. What's going on?
The what? Brew Bank? Alvarado, yeah, I can tell you were sick. I still can't make it. Brew Bank? Spell it.
Have him text you.
Bootleg. Bootleg. I got it. Right. Okay.
What's at the bootleg tonight?
Bootleg Theater on Alvarado.
I know the place.
Coming in. Here,
Beverly huh? Near Alvarado. That would be 2020. Here's the bootleg
theater on. I know
it. Well, that doesn't sound good at all. That's not what I wanted to hear. Getting out of the car at a federal building. Ick. Fuck.
Yeah. I'm with Kurt Kelly and Raven. Yeah. And Justin. Okay. Yes, we'll do. Thanks. Game mode. Game mode of what? What's he doing? Does he realize there's surveillance and, like, you know, bomb shields and everything all around this building?
He likes walking the line so much.
I know how that is. I've been there, and I still, you know, try and push the envelope, but I try not to attract the attention of law enforcement or government officials if possible.
Well hopefully it won't.
I'm already on the list of people they're rounding up, you know what I mean? Just for my, you know, perversions.
So what's going on? What did Diamond say?
Okay. She said, I just told you, Beverly, it's the Bootleg Theater.
I know, but what's going on? Why are we going to go there? What's there?
I don't know. Why don't you ultimately text him and ask him? He's still at the whiskey.
I mean, you didn't ask him? Yeah, I texted him. Ask him what's up. Yesterday, his comedian friends were performing there. We were going to go, but...
At the Bootleg Theater?
Yeah, but he was getting his hair cut. Kurt was getting his hair done and stuff. And then by the time we were going to go over there, he was already gone. But that sounded fun.
It's L-U-B-L-E, right?
Why didn't Mike pick you up?
He was at the Whiskey. I'm in Marina Del Rey.
Oh.
He would, you know, by the time we got back there, it'd be over.
I'm glad you came with us. Yay. Are you having a nice visit with your daughter?
She's gone.
Oh,
left.
She's gone.
I got her to the train station this morning, yeah.
Okay.
But, we're both late night. We were up till 5 in the morning. We both are anyway. Her natural bedtime's like 3. Mine's 5. So. But last night she outdid me. I went to bed early because I had to get up at 6. I had to take a shower and everything to get her. She just had to go on the train.
Mm-hmm.
Because I had a meeting with her attorney. I admire my attorney, Bernie. Ever hear that song?
reinstall Google Music. Save my song.
Play it.
I need another phone. I need a different phone. One has more memory. I'm juggling programs all the time. I hacked the operating system, so there's no fat on here. Of all the bloatware the Virgin put on there is long gone. But you know, it's $175 unsubsidized phone from 2 years ago. It just doesn't remember.
Right.
Yeah. Once you get rid of the crap, if you buy a Nexus phone, they come with an unlocked bootloader. You don't have to hack. Just replace the OS with CyanogenMod.
Which comes with Nexus.
Nexus is Google's reference platform for Android. And they're made by either Motorola or LG, depending which version it is. But they come with unlocked bootloaders. You don't have to hack them to replace the ROM. It's like ready to go.
Mm.
Yeah. It's carriers that put all that crap on. If I kept the bloatware that Virgin left on here, forget it. It would be useless. Like it's already installed. How about that? How about that? No, it's not. Where are you?
What did you do today, Justin?
Cartoons?
Yeah.
Cool.
Well, there it is. What's up? Oh, it's called Google.
We're still recording.
What kind of cartoons?
We're not being very funny anymore.
It's like, you know, like where they have backstory to, like, you know, during these live footage interviews, they have these backstories, and so they're told, you know, with animation.
Fuck!
What? Dang, it is
Holy fuck! Holy fuck, it's cold out! Jesus Christ!
Yeah,
I'm just
watching.
Oh,
my God.
Oh, God. Fuck! What temperature is it? 10,000 degrees below zero. Holy fuck, it's cold out there. I'm hyperventilating, so cold out there. It's 55, you're lying, it's not 55, you fuckers. What's the real temperature? Where's the other phone?
Yeah, the phone's right here, recording.
No, the other one I just had. Oh, this one. Is it not 55? They're lying. It's, what is it? Fuck, it's cold. Oh, it's 55. Okay, it's really fucking cold. I'm glad I got other clothes in the trunk because I'm changing to the next bathroom I find. Fuck this. I am not wearing shorts the rest of the night. Oh, no fucking way. No. No, I'll have like fucking, I'll be dead from pneumonia in the morning. Holy shit.
Anyway,
it's fucking cold
out. Very hip, too. She comes off as, you know.
Who are we talking about?
Adrian Coleman.
Who's that?
Girl you were flirting with in the car on Sunset Boulevard.
Huh? Oh.
And guess what? She said the reason she liked eating tacos was to do with the tie. Same thing got kicked out of the bus. Okay?
That is interesting.
And whenever I was two 20-year-old French lawyers were sitting on my lap for like 2 hours. And then they met me again. They said, well, I can't marry
you. That was bad.
Adrian and another girl, or what?
No. I went to a fair with Ralph Reichman. These two French attorneys wound up sitting on my lap.
Can I share something?
20s, you know, beautiful. French girls, they're great.
John.
What?
I'm going to share something.
Yes.
Do you notice the flags?
Are they at half staff? Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Sure they are.
Do you know why they're at half staff?
Yes.
Yeah, and two U.S. Marshals just told me the reason why they're half staff. Do you know why they're half staff?
You weren't the only known.
No, it's because an American lost their life, and they don't know how many more are still back in the hospital. So far, one American is dead.
Did they get by the other guy?
I didn't ask for any more details. That was more debriefing than I was ready for at that moment.
Well,
especially since 160 people died that I know of, maybe more. Maybe this was 161. I don't know yet, but... I'm upset by this because the breach happened to my network that may have been involved in some of this. I hope Salas, I was right, that can never trace it back to me. Fuck, that would just suck.
Like I said.
Horse cock.
The NSA works under my security.
Okay, well, if they're under your security, tell them to start lighting up the assholes and get them off the street. That's so close to accurate, it's actually worse. The nail on the pinky. The nail on the pinky doesn't even know what the pinky's doing. It's that bad. Everybody's spying on everybody from every agency on the planet. Everybody's sucking.
Like they built a ton of housing in Fort Ord, and then they closed Fort Ord and all this housing there.
Well, but that's for the future. No. That's going to become a prison if they decide to martial law goes on. Okay, that's what a prison looks like. Have you ever been in a prison, John? I have.
Yes.
I've been in prison more than once, as you know.
I've been in prison once for a 90-day diagnosis.
Oh, poor baby.
But I've been in jail.
Okay, so that was because you were nuts. Good ties on your head again.
He's been in county jail for months.
Is there cigarettes in here?
Is there cigarettes in here?
No, cigarettes. That's how. Is there any air? Four packs, I can't smoke four packs in there. Oh, here's one. Never mind, disregard my phone.
Okay.
Other pocket that he wanted me to empty, and I said, no, I'm not emptying pockets. I don't want everybody to know I have 14 packs of cigarettes on me. It's not for everybody's own. And they'll say, hey, look for the guy who looks like this. And then I'll be giving away cigarettes all night. I don't want to do that. So, being selective about who is what. Joe Walsh used to live at the top of this building in that there. Sweet. And I used to get calls from 2 or 3 in the morning. Grant, yeah, come over. I got Stevie Nicks here and everybody. And we're working on a song that we want to play on the air in the morning. Come on over.
Like right on
and my
block.
Ex-wife used to go fucking nuts.
Closer to Westwood, but she's still there.
And I'd show up and they would be there. And we're working on music, so we had to go in and be on the air live at 6 in the morning. And he'd show up drunk and shit, but he'd be a genius on the air. So I didn't give a shit. He could be as drunk as he wanted to. He was a rock star. That's what he wanted. That's what he wanted. When he showed me a paycheck stub for $50 million from ASCAP BMI from the in 1985 when the Eagles had me in 23 years, I went, fuck, I'm a big rock star. He's got to give me a shitload of money and they don't even show up. Because he got it from his James Gang royalties, the Eagles, his solo stuff. He had done so much stuff by 1985. His annual royalties alone were $50 million if he never strummed it in the middle.
Royalties?
Yeah.
$50 million a year?
Yeah. That was his ASCAP check. He showed it to me. It was real. He showed it to me before he cashed it. He said, this is my paycheck for sitting around this year. That was right after life's been good so far. Of course it's been good. With those kind of paychecks, I'd say that's pretty good. He had houses he had never lived in. The song was a true song about his life. He has Maserati. He drove 185. When they took away his license and now he can't drive, he used him to drive the rest of the time. Because when he drives to drive 185. That's Joe's speed. That's where Joe and I used to drive fast together. He got his license taken away. I had an attorney.
His songs are true autobiography.
They always are. They always have been. He showed up late for Thanksgiving dinner once, and my wife was so pissed off she didn't even want to serve him, so he brought his guitar and sat down and played to our Sheltie dog and wrote a song on the spot, my dog and me, and then she served him dinner like he was a queen. Because he played a song to our dog and our dog didn't bark. The hyper Sheltie sat still and listened to Joe sing the entire song about my dog and me. Me and my dog. And it was the cutest thing I've ever seen. The rest of the night the dog was licking him and running around chasing him and was totally relaxed because Joe was there. Of course, we're smoking some bomb ass weed, so the dog is probably high as a fucking kite. Yeah. Yeah, there are some real bitches that are groupies. Mine was a Sheltie. She was a little Sheltie bitch, but she was thoroughbred. She had to be because.
I don't remember the name. Oh, it's Dave Fishburne. Fishburne.
Oh, yeah, I know his name. I don't remember from what, but his name's familiar. What has he done?
He's done my attorney, Bertie, which is.
He did your attorney? Wow, did you get pictures?
Right now.
Did you get pictures of him doing your attorney?
What, do you need a letter?
No, I was tapping it because I thought that was a funny joke. I'm sorry. I thought it was funny. you have pictures of them doing your journey.
Here it is. Oh, well, okay, now thanks for...
Love this song.
All the trouble of finding the song, thanks for that.
Oh, you were looking for this?
No.
What song you got?
My Attorney Bernie.
Who sings it?
David Frischberg.
Oh, all right. Is it any good or is it a piece of shit?
No, it's quite...
Illuminate me, Doctor. I'll let the dust go by. Will it be today or next week?
Yes, it will be... Today is...
All right, let me know when you're ready.
Well, there's no... Oh, here we go. Yeah.
Okay. Well, you're about to lose it again. You're about to hit a dark spot. Because Nancy Reagan still lives up here. Let me know when you're ready.
I got it.
Yeah, you're about to lose the signal again. They'll wipe it on this pad.
Doesn't matter. It's downloaded.
Oh, all right. Well, then rock out. Can't remember what he hears that well. Don't like his voice. Not my kind of music. I don't think he's that good. Sorry. Do you like him?
Is it a joke?
Huh?
Is it a joke?
It's not a joke. It's like humorous
music.
Take on something we all have to deal with.
Yeah.
It's not
the law.
Not what I try to break. I wouldn't want my name on that record. And look at me like I lost
my
hearing.
That's his one hit record.
Oh my God. Probably because it was such a novelty. People thought, give him a shot.
Well, Dave Frischberg, I mean, he's a humorist first. He's a satirist, isn't he? Yes, political satirist first.
Me? I'm a rock and roll guy. And pop.
Electronic.
Electronic. If it's good music, it has to be good music. I like electronic if it's good.
I like dark wave industrial, which they play in the same clubs, but it's not exactly like EDM.
Yes, it'd be right.
Or house music.
Like this I like.
More ponderous, and it's always a dirty, but it is a great music.
Me and Kurt get along very well, but we don't agree on music.
Well, I know what I can sell. I know what I can make gold.
I love that.
Like, I can make this multi-platinum. I can blow this record up.
I like that one.
I could probably sell 10 million copies of this.
They've got software that has 65%
stay right.
Whether or not a song is a song.
Yes. Call me on my cell phone. Love this song. Late night when you need my love. I know when I like me. And if I was going to put this on a rock station, I'd add a wailing ass motherfucking guitar. And I could make this a rock record. It's the exact song. You put a chorus behind it.
Ever since I left the city, I am not as drunk as I want to be right now.
You will be.
You have a Klonopin.
I want an Adderall. Huh? I want an Adderall.
That's all
Adderall.
You need is an Adderall.
I need one Adderall.
No problem.
One Adderall, doctor.
I can't wait to see
you. Oh, you better fasten your seatbelt, buddy. Oh, it'll blow your mind. I won't be asleep for a week.
I'm guessing not so much.
ADD is not my issue.
Can I give away your cigarette?
That's why I said I keep the people I want to go to. John, I think they should let you and I do a live HBO special. I think we're ready. It's been 30 years. Let's do it. What
do
the fuck?
You want to just, like, share one with me?
No, you can have separate cigarettes.
No, me and Justin like to share. So we have small reserves. I don't know how to say it. What is it?
What is it?
You know what? If you're not, you should take them.
What, is it Adderall?
Oh, yeah.
Is it Adderall? Is it Adderall?
No, it's Klonopin.
Oh, have you ever taken it before?
This is a Adderall. It's not time release. It's generic. You know, it's a
Where's
Adderall.
Mine?
Yeah. And Kurt wants Adderall.
Here you go, Kurt.
Is it the same one?
Okay, thanks.
Okay. Have you taken the Adderall too?
Okay.
I've already taken I want to do half. Yeah, half.
Time out. Time out, everybody. Time out 1 second. Has anybody ever taken this before him and I? Have you ever taken it?
I have. Well,
I take it. I've been taking it.
I'm not asking you, John. John, stop a second. Have you ever taken it?
I've taken Adderall before.
How long ago?
Probably.
Okay, if you haven't taken it recently, I would say start with a quarter to a half, test it.
Yeah.
And don't fuck around until you're really sure you're on balance. I want to save the other one for another day. I'm cautioning you because I took a whole one once and I wasn't ready. I was up for 5 days.
Yeah.
Because I'm not ADD, so it doesn't affect me the way it affects you. With me, it's like giving me cocaine.
Because, you know, it's like already cut for a while.
Well, that's why I said a quarter. I said start with a quarter.
Exactly.
I didn't say half. He said half.
Yeah,
but he's doing it all the time.
Yeah, you took it, you were studying for a test or something? For your college?
I think my friend gave me a pill a few years ago, whatever, and I took half of it at the studio. She said he had strong, take only half.
Took a quarter,
and
right?
I took half and I was chewing my own fucking tongue.
Okay, yeah,
I'd rather have you take a quarter and be safe than risk it.
Yeah, I'm real
you,
sensitive.
I'd have to rush you to an emergency.
Yeah.
I don't want to rush you to an emergency.
Well,
you okay, Anna? What should I watch for if there's a problem? What are the signs?
Oh, if there's a problem, I'll ask
what
for
are
help.
The signs? Just in case you're not able to, what are the signs? You pass out, what happens?
I'll just say H-E-L-P if I can't. If
you're
I can't say the word, I'll slow
down.
If
nothing, squeeze me. If you can't do anything more, at least squeeze.
Okay, I'm going to be pinching him.
Potpourri, that's your safe word.
If she starts pinching anyone, she can't talk. No, seriously.
Did you really say that?
Yeah, you did. Why?
Isn't that what I said? Wasn't that my word? What was my word? What was my safe
for
word?
What? It wasn't potpourri.
It wasn't?
No. No, it was something that fit any conversation or something. I don't remember.
I already forgot. Okay. I guess that was...
How about I want your help?
Huh? Yeah, right?
How about I want your help?
Parsimonious.
I want your help.
Oh, wait, what do you want?
No, that could be
separate.
Hey, I want your help understanding this, so I want your help.
Okay.
And then I could say, well, what do you mean? And then you can clarify.
No.
All right.
See, this doesn't help. I already speak directly, so I don't need to have any safe words.
Well, you were the one who said safe word.
No, I wasn't.
Who said safe word?
It's hard to use your safe word.
Whoa.
Wait a minute, now I'm the one that brought up the whole idea.
Yeah.
No.
Who brought up safe word?
You did.
When?
You're like, maybe we need to have a safe word in case I'm getting out of control.
That was for me.
Or maybe, you know.
That was for me. Those were my safe words.
Quit sniveling.
And I said, you said, I don't know of any right now. I said, think
and
of one and let me know what it is.
I need a safe
See?
Word.
See, and so that's what you're saying.
When I was 17 years old, my father took
I know I need them.
To the back of Silly Sally's massage parlor, which was here.
Yes, it
and
was.
And for the first time in my life, I saw a chick shoot 100 dioxin.
She shot off what?
Pharmaceutical meth.
Oh. Ooh, I've seen that. I fucking hate that shit. When they burn the spoon
and
shit.
And then went out and sucked the dicks because it wasn't really a massage parlor. Okay? Nobody was getting a massage there. It was 1970.
No, you are aware we are recording, just so you're aware.
Well, okay, so, you know.
I just didn't want you to be blind saying, why'd you record that? I disclosed. You know. I'm like, did you? Yeah.
Well, you know, it's nice to
He used to own this spot right here. His parents used to own this. No, it was down further. No, they really didn't.
Oh, you mean
the House of Booze. The House of Booze.
This
spot right here used to be a Barrymore estate called Butterfields, right?
No, Butterfields is there. The patio has been vacant for 30 years. Where the House of Blues is now was a Roy's Chinese restaurant, Roy's Silver.
Yes, it was.
It was all like Lady of Shanghai.
But everybody thought it was owned by the Barrymores. It wasn't. You know, they were just there a lot.
It was Roy that started out from John Barrymore's hunting lodge and all that.
Right. The Barrymore hunting lodge. Butterfields on Sunset.
There was a lot of game here.
Yeah.
Not the kind he shot.
This show shithole's been here forever, and the guy who owns it is a complete asshole.
I lived halfway down this block for years.
This is where I first met, who's the lady who was on Melrose? No.
Carlos and Charlie?
Yeah. No, Carlos and Murphy's. the lady who married in John Blonde Lady, Heather. That's where Heather Locklear and I first had dinner when she was working at ABC.
Mary John who?
The girl from John Bond, who's his guitar player.
Oh.
What's this fuck? The drunk one. That she left him because
Kenny
he
Hagar?
No. From Bon Jovi.
I don't know.
I think it was the lead guitarist or the bass player she was married to for several years, and they split up a couple years ago.
Did you say Sam Morrow?
Thank you. It was Sam Morrow she was married to. And I knew her before she was even dating him. In fact, I think she had just stopped dating Charlie Sheen.
Oh, you hear that thing about Charlie Sheen?
Which one?
That he has HIV, he's been giving it to everybody without
No, I haven't. Wow, I hope that's not true. I hope that's a lie.
Apparently there was a rumor that some tabloid said some A-list actor.
I don't think it's
him. I don't think
he's
A-list actor.
I've seen Charlie recently. Bullshit.
He came out today and announced he announced he had HIV.
What did he announce?
He's been giving it to people without their knowledge.
What did he announce?
Well,
that he has AIDS?
Yes.
Well, he did announce it?
Huh?
He announced it?
I think he announced it because they were about
I'll bet if you Google it, there's nothing out of it. I'll bet money. Charlie Sheen with AIDS.
CHA and Charlie Sheen, the first thing that came up. Okay. Charlie Sheen. Denise Richards knew Charlie Sheen was HIV positive for years. Charlie Sheen will reportedly disclose HIV diagnosis.
I want to see what he said. Charlie I don't give a shit what they think.
Heather Locklear.
Yeah.
Lends support to Charlie Sheen in wake of the HIV.
Does he really have it?
Apparently so. Charlie Sheen believes HIV is undetectable in his blood.
Well, if it's undetectable,
Charlie Sheen is HIV positive. Charlie Sheen is HIV positive because could his exes sue him?
Yes. Well, not if he didn't know. If he knew, yes. If he didn't know.
Apparently, still true.
If he knew and withheld it.
For years.
Oh, shit,
why
he's fucked.
She say anything?
Whoa, he's fucked. Huh. He's fucked. He recklessly gave it to him and didn't disclose. Unless he got them to sign a release, he's fucked. Oh, shit. Wow, that's reckless endangerment of someone's health. They could bring charges against him, even criminal.
Oh, yeah.
Could be attempted manslaughter.
Yeah.
Because he knowingly gave them AIDS. Wow, that's serious shit.
Charlie Sheen's former goddess opens up after HIV revelation.
Oh, my God, that makes me sick to my stomach to hear.
Charlie Sheen's gross HIV guessing game takes us back to
back to the 80s.
Tabloid for Charlie Sheen.
Oh, shit, he's fucked. He is fucked. You better get some really good attorneys. He's fucked.
Is anyone pressing charges?
Well, they will now. They'll be like Bill Cosby. They'll all be coming out of the fucking woodwork.
You know he's a man
whore. The shitstorm's about to happen. Who's got my lighter? I can't find it.
He's all about lighter. Going barebacks.
Thank you. Wow, that's sad.
Charlie Sheen, threats of lawsuits unravel the HIV secret. TMZ.com.
It's a shitstorm's about to fly. It always is. You think it's little and it's not. When you lie on that big a level, that's huge.
That's really huge.
That's huge. I can't work with him now after that. Shit, I can never work with Sheen again. He lies. Oh, fuck. That saddens me. Wow, that really saddens me. I've known Charlie for over 30 years. Wow. Wow. I mean, I'll still be civil with them.